the good friends, the ones we hold dear, the ones who will tell us what we need to hear, the ones who love us, right or wrong. And to all those good friends, I give you this song.
Well, hello, good friends, and welcome back to The Last Fork, Remember When, with your host, Ron Baumbach. And we're going back again on our time travel journey to our fun times of your lives. The Last Fork, Remember When. And we are going back again to the third part of our chapter of recollecting the shows we've done over the last 6.5 years. A lot of shows. This is number 335. And we're moving along, moving and grooving in these shows. So, get up off your easy chair, walk into your kitchen, open up that refrigerator, the icebox. Reach way in the back, get that aluminum can of the original soda in aluminum can, original cola, RC Cola. Pop it open, make sure it sizzles and fizzles and tickles your nose. And go up in the cupboard, reach in the back, get that box of dozen Mr. Donut donuts your dad bought yesterday. There's still a few left. They aren't crinkled at all yet. Get some out. Go back to your easy chair. Turn on your lava lamp. Close your eyes. It's storytelling time. The Last Walk is back.
Life is too short. We get only one turn. With luck we find beauty, but we sometimes get burned. But if you've had a true friend, or perhaps in love, you've experienced the peace of heaven above.
Goes and flows of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air and feathered canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I recall. I really
yes, that's the beautiful, wonderful Judy Collins. Anyways, a good song, Both Sides Now. She talks about didn't know love. I didn't know love back then, but I do now. I'm so lucky. And we are talking about our shows from the past. So what better way to bring it back in about the toys from yesterday and the things we did yesterday than to have Judy Collins wrap it up for us in the beginning of our show. Wrap around the song from way back when. We talked about a guy named Kilroy. Remember Kilroy was here? The expressions we used from our youth. And the games we played. Remember those games we played? Stickball, steal the flag, running bases, hide and seek, all those wonderful things. And I want to thank one special thing I got. After one of our shows, our first show about recalling the old shows, I mentioned I've been trying to get Jax. Looking for Jax, can't get the real Jax. Well, lo and behold, my buddy Mike found a set of authentic Jacks and the ball that came with it. And I'm in heaven now, baby. In fact, my next talk's in a few weeks. I'm bringing those Jacks, bringing that ball, and we're going to have a wild time together at the library when I give my presentation. Thanks, Mike. And those are the things we talked about, the games from years ago. And Judy Collins talked about them in her song.
The dizzy dancing way you feel when every fairy tale comes real. get love that way.
Well, I hope Judy found some love. She deserves it. I think she's still around in Seattle, Washington. The wonderful Judy Collins. And we spoke about reunion, speaking about getting together with people. Reunion of old friends. We had a get-together. My sister organized. We had everybody go back to our block again some 50 years later, 30 years later, 20 years later, 10 years later. And we get together on Facebook. We chat, we talk, and we use our real names, not the names I made up in the book. We talked about the stores we went to. Remember Gert's, Macy's, Gimbel's? Macy's still around. Gimbel's is long gone. A lot of the old stores that we knew from way back then, the old ones, the brick-and-mortar stores, as they call them, are now gone, and we're dealing with cyber stores. The internet, Walmart.com, Amazon.com, all these things that are so different than we knew as children. I wonder if you can actually buy candy.com and have it just appear at your doorstep. All of a sudden, here comes a candy bar. Imagine if Good Humor came, Bungalow Bar comes, all of a sudden, cyberways. You hear that ding, 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 and then all of a sudden you come out and it appears in your mailbox. I don't know. We talked about the Roger Fay, a local politician who put me on the map with my book. Died at 100 years of age, with mayor of New York City, a dear friend of my parents, and a wonderful man to many, many people. Him and his wife, Nora, and the family, we cherished their friendship for many, many years. And thank him for everything he did for us. We talked about the old movie theaters and the drive-in theaters. Remember going to the drive-in? Those crazy things you pulled up. You had that little metal thing you put into the window. You crank the window down. You crank the window up. And you have your speaker. A lot different now. We're all watching movies in our home or going to the theaters that are reopening again. And we talked about happy Halloween memories. When I had my sister and her friends over, and I used some olives, pretending they were eyeballs, and some spaghetti, pretending they were hair, we had a great time. I did at least, scaring those little 10-year-olds. And how about school days? Kindergarten to fifth grade. And my famous fart, when some kid hit me in the head with a big book, and my only reaction was, which I didn't know why, but what hit me on the head one end came out the other end, and the whole class enjoyed the fun of hearing that thing going on. And we did elections. We reviewed the elections from 1952 to 2012 and 2016 and 2020. We went over all the elections, the politics, the crazy times. Isn't it so much better years ago? But don't we always say that? Didn't our parents always say that? And our parents' parents always said that? Everyone always says it was way back better, way back when. So someday your grandkids and my grandkids are going to say, remember the good old days of 2022, 2023? Oh, those were the days, my friend. Amazing. Hopkins Wang, thank you so much for that wonderful song that brings us back to those were the days. And you know, they're always the days, aren't they? That tavern she mentioned, she had in her song. Didn't you have a tavern? Remember your first time you imbibed in an actual cocktail? My friends and I, my buddies, we go on Tommy Tuesday. One day a month, we call it Tommy Tuesday. go to a lovely place called the Little Lounge, and we have our little luncheon, sit around with a bunch of guys, like 6, 7, 8, 10 guys, and we solve all the problems of the world for about an hour and a half. We walk out, everything's fixed, and we fix it again a month later. It's incredible. Back in school, we had the Brown Derby, and years ago, we had the Skipper. It just keeps on going and going and going, just as long as you don't imbibe too much. Just go there, do your thing, have a good time, talk, chat, and get out, and keep doing your good stuff to everyone else. Speaking of which, we talked about Thanksgiving, the Thanksgiving days, and Black Friday, and all the shopping you had to do to get ready for Christmas, and Hanukkah, and your special holiday. And we spoke about my radio show back in school, back in Marist College, WMCR Radio, in the days where Mike and I ran the radio station, and we had fun doing it. We got in trouble with the FCC, I think it was, because we broadcasted too loud, too far, too wide, all across the Hudson River, and we got a letter to cease and desist. So my good buddy Mike went up on the roof of the ninth floor of Champagne et al., figured a way to turn off the antenna, which he had made a nine-story antenna, and he made it lower the signal so we didn't get in trouble any longer. And things were back to being normal. Fun days. And we did things about the New Year's and Christmas celebration, and memories of Santa Claus coming to your home, and my memory of my dad knowing Santa Claus, and memories of our grandkids witnessing the fact that what joy Santa brings. And we spoke about the real meaning of Christmas, what Jesus did, Mary did, Joseph did, and how it affected all our lives many, many years later. And why I do believe in Santa, and that is the real meaning, what's behind the message.
Oh, I've been so lucky, and I've been so blessed. In spite of my failings, I've found success. For I've known love, and I've known good times, and I have known friendship, and written some rhymes.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. The taste of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet. I fell for you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Hey, Ron, why'd you use that song? What do you mean, I like the song? Well, why'd you put that one on? It has nothing to do with your show. Why'd you doing that? It doesn't make any sense at all. Well, it does make some sense, my buddy. Because you see, my brother Dick got me onto this thing, and Johnny Cash is his favorite performer. And when I was a kid, when I saw those guys doing those Ring of Fires with the magic fire flames, throwing flames, I said, these guys are freaking nuts. They're going to burn themselves. I never figured out how they did it. Must be some kind of fire that doesn't go out. And it was from way back when. And they still do these crazy things. But anyway, back to your question. Yeah, my question was, why'd you do it? Because I wanted to do it, okay? And let's go on to what we're talking about. Years ago and the shows we did for some 6+ years. Well, we discussed Valentine's Day. And my favorite Valentine's Day memory was my first one with my bride. And I had some odd Valentine's Day memories as well, which we talked about in our show. And the greatest football game ever played, the Giants. And we couldn't see it in New York because it was blacked out. And a neighborhood scientist, my buddy Steve Thomas, who's now up in heaven. And the day we launched some frogs into space from the mini oil lots. How about random acts of kindness? We spoke about people doing random acts of kindness, racks. How nice they are, how cherished they are to society. Those are the real heroes. And we spoke about heroes, our Mother's Day, Father's Day heroes, and all the godmothers, grandmothers, mothers, and the fathers, godfathers, uncles, aunts, who mean so much to us all these years. And how about how to ride a bike? Remember the day you rode a bike, the first day you actually got the training wheels off? We were recently watching a Peppa Pig episode with one of my granddaughters, Emily, and we noticed that Peppa Pig must be produced in England. They did not call them training wheels. They called them, what were they called? Hold on, let me think this thing out. It'll come back to me. Yes, I'm thinking of the episode. Emily sat in my lap and it was called Stabilizers. Whoop, there it is, the button. That's the winning single. Who thinks of these things? Who thought of the word stabilizer? Makes sense though, right? I think I like training wheels a little better, but stabilizer sounds more macho. I got my stabilizer. Training wheels like could be training? Who knows? Who wants to be trained? I want to learn. I want to know it. I want to have it and succeed in it and ride that two-wheeler through town and off we go. And that's what we spoke about. How you learned how to do a bicycle and who you taught over the years. Your children, your grandchildren, and how great you did doing that as you ran alongside of them and then let them go as they rode down and hopefully didn't crash. We spoke about the greatest football game ever played, the Giants. And we couldn't see it in New York because it was blacked out way back when. And my neighborhood scientist, our favorite guy, Steve Thomas, who unfortunately is no longer with us, but he's up in heaven right now. But we launched some frogs into space from the mini oil lots years ago. And we discussed Valentine's Day memories. My favorite Valentine's Day long time ago with my bride before she was my bride. And the weird holidays I've had of Valentine's Day memories. But not with my bride. Boo, some crazy times. And the buddy bench, a great thing the schools have now for the kids who have no one to play with. Sit in the buddy bench and someone walks over and talks to you and maybe you become a friend for life. Speaking of which, is random acts of kindness. We had a good chat about those. Random acts of kindness, the things that make the world a lot better.
Here's to good friends, the ones we hold dear. The ones who will tell us what we need to hear. The ones who love us, right or wrong. And to all those good friends, I give you this song.
You've been listening to The Last Walk, Remember When, with your host, Ron Baumbach. We're on this multi-part journey about the days from our past, recalling the shows we've done for over 6.5 years now. So we're doing a memoir, a walk back in time on our time on the shows we've had on TNR Radio. And we thank you for listening. And we thank my buddy Paul Cassone for the great song, Here's to Good Friends, heard on our show. And to my buddy Mike, my college roommate who works tirelessly to make our show and our voice sound so much better, from the great state of Tennessee, where he has an incredible studio with all these oopsie-doopsie things that make magic out of my mess. And I want to thank you for listening all these years. And let's keep it going for a while more as we keep the fun going with more memories of what we did way back in time. The book, The Last Book on the Block, is available on Amazon.com and BarnesandNoble.com. It's a Nook print and Kindle version. Until next time, have a great weekend. Remember when.
Here's to good friends, the ones we hold dear. The ones who will tell us what we need to hear. The ones who love us, right or wrong. And to all those good friends who give you this song. And to all those good friends who give you this song. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you. Because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your side. You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line.